Hi, my name is Ray Kelly, and I'm a Fortify Solutions Architect. Today we'll be looking at how to create a WebInspect API client. There's several reasons why you would want to make a client application. WebInspect is fully extensible with its RESTful API, and some things you may want to do is automate your web application scans. You may want to pull scan results down in an automated fashion so you can upload them to your bug tracking software. Another example is integrating them into your custom processes and workflows. So if you're using, say, Jenkins or some other build pipeline, you can integrate WebInspect into those pipelines and have them fully automated. Another example would be your CI/CD pipeline. The WebInspect API is based on a Swagger, so it's a self-documenting API. It allows you to test specific functions, so if you go to the API endpoint for WebInspect, you can actually exercise the RESTful calls and get an idea of how to use those calls. Because it's Swagger, it's very easy to create a client-side application in pretty much any language that you'd want to choose. So let's see how this is done. Once you have WebInspect installed, the API will be available on port 8083 on localhost. So normally if you are running this on another machine, you'll want to open up ports so your CI/CD processes or your custom apps can access the endpoint. So when you hit the URL, you'll be able to see the RESTful API here. And underneath, you can see all of the calls that are available to you. And as an example, we can exercise the get method of scans. And I'll do a filter on zero, which is one of our test applications. This particular call will list all scans that have been stored within WebInspect. We'll try it out. And there we go. We can see the response. And here's some details on each scan that was run. And so this is what the Swagger API looks like. The next thing we're going to do is, since we want to write our own application, we need to go get the actual payload for this API. So you can do that by taking this and pasting it into the URL. And here is the entire API, the RESTful API definition. And so to make this easy, we're going to grab the raw data and select all of it and copy it. And we're going to use something called the Swagger Editor. So this is on Swagger's website, editor.swagger.io. And this will help you create a client very easily. So I'm going to select all. Pet store is by default, but we'll go ahead and paste in our definition that we grabbed for WebInspect. And you can see here that it just replicated everything. You can ignore this error. So the next thing we're going to do is generate a client. And you can see all of the different languages that it supports. And for this example, I'll use C#. So if we want to write a .NET or a MVC type application, we'll use that as an example. And so it just generated a client for us, and it zipped up the project. And I'm going to go ahead and save that, and I will extract that.
So once you've unzipped the Swagger client-side zip file into a folder, you're able to open that now in your IDE. So again, for instance, we're using C#, so I'm using Visual Studio. And we can see it created a folder for us and actually created a solution. So we'll open that up. And we can try to build. Let's just make sure it builds cleanly. And I've noticed this before where it doesn't update NuGet packages when you open it. So sometimes you'll need to do that. So we'll go and update the NuGet package. And REST sharp. So we'll install the latest version of that. All right, and then hopefully if we clean the solution and rebuild, And now we're good. So the solution built. If we go and look at what was created for us, you can see the entire API is created automatically, all documented as well. So using the Swagger client utility, it creates 90% of the code for us to get started. So it's very helpful. So to demonstrate that, I'll go ahead and add a new project. And we'll just use a WinForms app. And we'll add a reference to our Swagger project. And I'll add a list box out here. And a big button. We'll just say this is get scans. Add a reference to our using statement for our library. So it's io.swagger. So now we can create an object. And for instance, usually you'll use the scanner API. Call it scanner. If we look at the methods, you can see here's all of the methods that we can do for scans. Export a settings file, generate reports, get macros. Here is get scans, which is we'll use for our example. And again, you can see how it's helpful with the inputs. It describes everything that you may want to specify for each call. And in this case, we will filter on scans for our zero website. Actually, we should set that to a variable. I will just loop through our results and add them to our list box. And again, the objects are well-defined. So you can see we have our name, the start time of the scan, or the status of the scan. For this example, we'll just use the name. And that is it. We'll start this up and see how it works. And we'll click our button. And there's all of our scans that WebInspect has done for our zero website. And that is how easy it is to create a client-side API. For more information, you can visit our Fortify on-demand website or follow our Twitter page. And you can also find more videos on how to use our solutions and products. Thank you for watching.